definitely, and you can see that, especially the defensive movement. They're trying to get back there pretty quickly. They just kind of fell down, get the bearings about them, and play some football.
Here we go. There's the snap. The kick is up. It's short. And it goes to the left. The kicker, a 8-yard pass from Michael Lopez to Jason Cook, that starts this ball game off here today at the six-man state football championship. Witt Herald 6, North nothing. 8 minutes, 6 seconds to go in the first quarter. And North should have their first opportunity to touch the ball.
There's an onside kick. It's off inside the 30. It may have been recovered by Witt Herald. It has been an onside kick that the North Longhorns let go by the 30-yard line in terms of it going out of bounds, Trent. Has been recovered by Witt Herald. Unbelievable. You can see it right off the bat what they were going to do. Witt let the ball behind them, didn't let it go through the ball quick enough. They had a play and catch up game, and now the Longhorns are going to have their back against the ball.
That's the only way to save right there. My goodness, what a chain of events here early in the first quarter as Witt Herald's going to get the football first and 15. And the ball is at the Gordon's 25-yard line from the spread formation. Quarterback Justin Strachner has the ball. He finds off one, and that pops it deep downfield.
It's caught! It's caught for a touchdown! Unbelievable!
Oh my God!
The Longhorns had a shot at him at about the 30. He avoided that and tossed the ball deep into the end zone. And Dockery comes up with it. There was some good coverage in the end zone by Joe Cosilla, but the pass was absolutely perfect. And this is a very unfamiliar situation for the Gordon Longhorns.
There he has to go. That's going to play a big part right here. Gordon can get out of this hole. There's the snap, the kick, the extra point attempt again. It's Wyatt Ryan. That may be a good omen, let's say, for the Gordon Longhorns. Witt Herald has been unable to convert on either of their extra point attempts thus far. So our new score, with just 7 minutes 56 seconds to go in the first quarter, is now Witt Herald 12 and Gordon nothing. And Brent, let's keep it right here. One of the interesting things we've been watching for just the last few minutes, the wind is trying to change directions here. We had a southerly breeze up until game time, and it looks now difficult to tell in a bowl situation, of course, with the wind swirling, but it looks like that wind may be switching around to a westerly direction, eventually to a northerly component, so we'll follow that as the game goes on.
Here's another onside kick by Witt Herald. This time it's recovered by Gordon inside their own territory at about the 39-yard line. Jim Costia picked that up right at the 39-yard line. Nice heads-up move for Gordon. And again, the lineup of the onside kick formation totally confused there. The Gordon Longhorns at that time, hey, they did a great job of picking it up. Gordon had some fantastic athletes. That's what he put on that very first line to make sure the outside is good line again.
Well, now this partisan Gordon crowd is ready to see some offensive action from their side of the field. And Castilla brings his men up to the line of scrimmage, tight formation, sides toward the backfield. Castilla going to throw it early on after receiver Chamberlain at the 25-yard line. Just overthrown. Looks like Chamberlain may have had some problems getting off the line of scrimmage, and that's what this Gordon crowd feels now. We have a huge contingent from the city of Gordon. I don't know who they left minding the store in Gordon, Texas, or for that matter, it was a Herald. But in any case, just about everybody is here. We have a great crowd here at the Mustang Bowl. Some people were making fun of us earlier for broadcasting to Gordon. Everybody's here. We know we have a lot of fans that are Gordon fans, but I haven't been a Welsh weather from everywhere else. Second and 15, there's a pitch back to Sizemore. He changes directions, but it's offside at about the 40-yard line. He's smothered by this Panther defensive unit. Let's see if they give him his forward progress. If they do, he picked up 3 yards. If they don't, he lost about 5. They do give him forward progress. That's going to bring up a 3rd and 13. Early going is very rough for the Gordon Longhorns. 3rd and 13, the incomplete pass on 1st and 15, and there the toss to Sizemore. And he picks up just 2 yards. So the Longhorns going with a stretch formation with Costilla at quarterback. Sizemore behind him. There's a pitch back to Sizemore. Now he can run with it or throw. Looking for someone. Has a receiver. It's number 22 for Gordon. He catches it at the 30-yard line. Now he comes back across the field, and he'll have the first down. He may have fumbled the ball, but in any case, it's going to be recovered by the Longhorns. That's Jake Calder on the receiving end of that pass from Jason Sizemore, and that's the first down for the Longhorns football game on their initial offensive series. If you're just joining us, 7 minutes to go in the first quarter. 12-0 with Harrell. As they scored on their first possession, then recovered an onside kick and scored again. From the spread formation, there's Matt Max Garcia. He has the sideboard looking for someone. Throws Garcia. He has it at the 20 down the right sideline. Knocked out of bounds at the 12-yard line. I love that formation. Have it back to the quarterback, get you back to the running back. The quarterback goes out so fast. I just think that it's a great way to run a football team because it's throwing everybody off. Nobody knows what the heck is going on in the backfield. And you get your best athletes in action every single time.
Well, when you have the athletes that the Gordon Longhorns do in terms of Jim Garcia, Jason Sizemore, Jesus Tafarina, Levin, and others, you're able to do that kind of formation. Now from the tight formation, here we go. Garcia pitches back to Sizemore, trying to pick his way up the middle of the field. He does to the 6-yard line. That should be enough for another first down, so it's going to be first and goal. Actually, they mark it at the 7-yard line, so first and goal for the Longhorns to listen to this crowd. Jason Sizemore just 3 yards rushing.